Welcome to the tutorial. Setup of the PID controller in easyE4 via function block DC. This video tutorial shows how to configure the DC function block for a PID controller. In addition, the mode of operation of the PID controller is shown using an application example with temperature control. The following technical requirements must be met. An easyE4 basic device. An EasySoft programming software version 7.x or 8.x. A license is required for the EasySoft programming software. You can download software, firmware, and updates at www.eaton.com/software. The easyE4 can provide up to 32 DC PID controller modules in one program. You can choose between unipolar or bipolar operating mode in the parameters for the function blocks. In the unipolar operating mode, a manipulated variable of 0 to 4095 increments is provided. In the bipolar mode, a manipulated variable of minus 4096 to plus 4095 increments is provided. In this video, the temperature regulation of a heating plate is demonstrated. This is where the PID controller with unipolar output is used. You can choose between unipolar or bipolar operating mode in the parameters for the function blocks. In the unipolar operating mode, a manipulated variable of 0 to 4095 increments is provided. In the bipolar mode, a manipulated variable of minus 4096 to plus 4095 increments is provided. In this video, the temperature regulation of a heating plate is demonstrated. This is where the PID controller with unipolar output is used. A tip. Select a function block in EasySoft with a single click and then press the F1 key to open the corresponding section for the block in Help. The PID controller is one of the continuous controllers, as it permanently determines the actual value deviation from the set point and reacts to the deviation with a manipulated variable. This manipulated variable then acts on the control variable with an actuator. This means that the function block requires two analog inputs for the set point and the actual value, MIC1 and I2, and an analog output for the manipulated variable, QV. The set point, I1, can have different sources. The operator can adjust the set point manually by means of a potentiometer. In the display screen of a visualization, the operator can enter a value. The target value is stored in a formula, or it is controlled by the control system depending on the process. The actuator is controlled by the manipulated variable, QV. These can be variable frequency drives, for example for speed, heating resistors, for example for temperature, control valves, for example for pressure or flow rate, servo motors, for example for angle of rotation. The controller can be deactivated by the program via the input EN, stands for enable. At the output QV, the manipulated variable is set to 0. But be careful! Consider the impact this will have on the process. Should the motor be stopped, the control valve completely closed, or the servo motor driven to the end stop? Or should there be a defined basic setting? For example, the control valve for water cooling should be set to 10% when the controller is deactivated. For this task, there is a solution: the manual manipulated variable of the PID controller. Should a minimum cooling water quantity be required when the controller is deactivated, this can be realized via the manual manipulated variable. In this case, the input enable must remain enabled. A value specification in increments must be transferred to the input MV and the digital input SE of the PID controller must be enabled. The 10% target is calculated as follows: 4,095 maximum increments times factor 0.1 for 10% equals sign 410 increments. This procedure permanently outputs a manipulated variable of 410 increments at the QV output of the PID controller until the input SE becomes false. Then the PID controller will output the calculated manipulated variable at output QV again. These are the two variants for putting a controller out of operation. First, enable false via manipulated variable 0. Second, enable true, SE true via manipulated variable equal sign MV in increments. Another analog input of the DC module is the one for the scan time TC. If the TC is set to zero, the controller is called up, for example, processed, with every program cycle. You can transfer values between 1 and 65,535, for example, 0.1 to 6,553.5 seconds to the function. As a result, the controller is only executed at the specified intervals. The scan time is included in the calculations of the I and D components of the algorithm. Please refer to the formula in help. The P, I, and D components of the control algorithm can be enabled separately by the program using the EP, EI, and ED inputs. At the analog inputs, KP, TN, and TV, enter the values for the proportional gain, reset time, and rate time. These determine the control response. In this way, you can switch the parameters on and off individually to commission your control system. The analog outputs QP, QI, and QD provide the values for the P, I, and D components of the manipulated variable QV. These values allow the controller settings to be evaluated during commissioning. The sum of all subresults produces the manipulated variable QV of the PID controller. These outputs are to be used for diagnostic purposes. The digital output LI indicates if the value range of the output QV is exceeded. In order to illustrate how a PID controller works, a test arrangement was set up. The control runs on an easyE4 control relay with temperature expansion module easyE4DC4PE1. The heating resistor is located in an aluminum plate that is heated by the controller. A PT1000 temperature probe is installed in the heating plate to measure the actual temperature. A fan on the heating plate allows cooling to be switched on to simulate a disturbance variable. With a total resistance of 48 ohm, RV plus RH, the maximum output current of 500 milliamps of the easyE4DC is not exceeded. The temperature probe for the ambient temperature is for display purposes only. The control system is operated and displayed using a process visualization system based on Galileo 10. This makes it easy to change and monitor values. A trend graph is used to record the actual temperature and the manipulated variable. The following is a block diagram of the main functions of the automation program on the easyE4. You can enter values for the control parameters and observe the behavior of the controller. The controller can be activated. P, I, and D components can be switched on or off, and the manual set point can be activated using the selector switches on the digital inputs of the PID controller. The manipulated variable for controlling the heating resistor is transferred directly to a pulse width modulation function block. The pulse width modulation controls the power of the heating resistor with the manipulated variable. In the line diagram of the visualization, all important variables of the control process can be observed over time. The temperature set point, the actual temperature, the manipulated variable, etc. The current numerical values are displayed below the diagram. To determine useful control parameters, the parameters for the P, I, and D components can be set and activated or deactivated separately. KP is indicated as a percentage. The value 4000% represents a 40-fold proportional amplification. Reset and rate times are set in 0.1 seconds units. A reset time of 1000 therefore results in a time value of 100 seconds. The fan of the test setup can be switched on using the disturbance variable on button. In this way, the heating plate cools down and the control mechanism works in the opposite direction. The automatic fan off causes the heating plate to be cooled automatically if the manipulated variable calculated by the controller is lower 10 increments. The heating output and mass of the heating plate were designed to ensure that the experimental setup provides sufficient time to observe the control process. The control process takes a little more than 20 minutes in real time, which is why the following recordings are played back at several times the normal speed. At the beginning of the recording, the temperature of the heating plate is approximately 25 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to the ambient temperature. The temperature set point is set to 34.5 degrees Celsius. KP, the proportional amplification, is set to 4,000%, which corresponds to a 40-fold amplification. The I and D components are deactivated. After approximately 15 minutes, the temperature has reached an actual value just below the temperature set point. A pure P controller never reaches the set point, which is why at least one I section must be added for the remaining difference. The I section of the controller was switched on in the right-hand half of the recording. You can see that the actual value continues to approach the set point, overshoots, undershoots briefly, and then the set point temperature is maintained. The parameters were determined empirically with a little experience and apply to this specific operating point of the controller. Other operating points require an adjustment of the control parameters. The parameters of more complex controlled systems must be calculated and or determined using simulations. Thank you for your attention.